Hey everyone, welcome. It's RedKool8360 here, bringing you some more UFC Undisputed 3. As you can see, I have switched over my video recording to my new MacBook. So we have adjusted a few things. This is my first recording in a long time of actually like recording and stuff. So we'll leave it up to that. Hopefully you guys enjoyed my new intro video, since the video was not transferring over to the new computer. We'll jump right into the game now. Alright, so I've gone through and looked at all these possible fights, and I have decided that we're going to go ahead and face Reggie Erickson. Seems like a decent fight. The real good fights, like the non-undercard, like, which is, means basically not a main fight or whatever, are against like 84s and we're like 67, so I really don't want to do that. And then we've got Marcel Cruz, who we've recently faced, and then another guy who I really do not like to face. So we're just gonna go ahead and go with this, and we will get our training sessions. Okay, so since I have recorded the last one, I know I said that I was gonna cut stuff out, and I did cut the training stuff out there. But I have also discovered that it is possible to have videos longer than the 15 minutes, so I won't worry about that. We're gonna go ahead and do the heavy bag drill. Try that. Which looks good. Alright, then we will also go ahead and do a camp session. I'm gonna try and level up some moves. I don't want to go to there yet. I'm going to go back to Black House. Alright. I like this. I like this kick. As you probably saw in the new intro video, like I was playing with just exhibition matches, and I was facing this one guy, Kendall Grove, and I got a nasty head kick which knocked him out. It was sweet. So, right now, one of my favorite moves. High impact kicks are always interesting. It's always weird, like, it doesn't actually make you do the correct move. It kind of lets you do a variety of them. I mean, it makes sense, because just having to throw, like, one move makes it harder to land them. Oh, God, this is awful. That was awful. I'm sorry, guys. Not real up to my standards. I haven't played this game in a while either, so we'll get there. Alright, so we'll get into the actual fight. Alright, let's go. This guy looks right down, but oh well. What can you say for creative people? Not sure how much. I think they just kind of random generation, computer generation. You don't really, I don't think they really looked at them and looked how dumb they looked. That's a big complaint I have about this game. Hopefully in this new EA Sports MMA they will fix fix that. I'm also hoping that they have more of a actual, like, you know how they have the face morphing thing or whatever. I hope that they do that for like a lot of the games with these new next gen consoles. I think that would be good. I mean, I always struggle with creating characters because, I mean, it's hard to do yourself because you can't see yourself. I made a fighter for my brother because he was trying to start up this game again. And he always struggled with it, and so he didn't actually get very far in it. So he just went ahead and created a new character. And I mean, I think it looks really close to him. And I mean, it's just, it'd be so much more. I like realistic in it. Double underhooks. I think that would help. I also hope that they get good like tattoos and create like different like things that you can customize. Like that's the thing. I like to customize, create my guy, make him look realistic and stuff. He lets him up. Nice high kick. Just punishing him. Oh, they're just throwing. Oh, they're exchanging here. Beautiful head kick there. Countering and scoring big time. He shoots at the over-under. Under 2 minutes remains. Belly to belly again. He's in the full guard here. Nicely done. Half guard. Able to posture up. Transitions to the full mount. Vicious. Oh, he's hurt. And again. He loves throwing that punch. Oh, he gets reversed. He's isolating an arm. He's got a Kimura. Come on.
Trying to remain patient.
Oh, that was rude, man. He faked me out there. That was bad.
Very nice. Good defense.
That was pushes him off real bad in my part.
Oh, oh, big right hand. He's down. Oh, he's back to his feet. Oh, good combination. Oh, those are vicious. Spinning back fist. Oh, beautiful hook. It is all over.
That's it.
All right, that's nice knockout. That's nice knockout, especially coming at the end of the round there. Real close, wasn't. I honestly didn't think that I was gonna get it. I thought he's calling it for the round. That was good.
Let's take a look at that again. Look at the timing of this hook, Mike. Let's see it one more time. He just nails him with that.
That's a highlight reel knockout right there, Joe.
Here we see it again, close up.
And with our official decision, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 57 seconds. Of the very first round, declaring the winner by knockout, Jake Destruction Prime.
Destruction is your victor.
All right, guys. Well, that was a real good fight. Real quick, nice knockout. I mean, he wasn't necessarily great competition, but I mean, it's not like we knocked him out within the first minute either. So, we will look to improve. Maybe we will step up to the next level next time. I'm kind of hesitant to take too much as we've got those two losses now. But we'll look to improve and see what we can do next. So until next time, it's Red Kool-Aid 360. See you later.